class. I'm going to be demonstrating a newborn assessment. As this baby has just been born, the baby has been handed off to you because you are the baby nurse, and I'm going to be demonstrating what you are responsible for in caring for this baby in the first few minutes of life. Of course, I'm prepared as that baby is being delivered. I already have I've washed my hands, I have put my gloves on, and I am ready to go. I have my radiant warmer set up with suction. I have my supplies that I need that we're going to be going through with each one, or as we go through the simulation. So the baby is handed off, okay? I immediately start drying vigorously, not rough. Oh, it's okay. And trying to get all the blood and the fluids and everything off this baby. As soon as that towel gets soiled, I'm going to take it off and get a clean, dry one. And also, hopefully, I've had time to warm these blankets prior to that baby being delivered. Okay, sweetheart, it's all right. It's okay. You're good. You're good. Okay. While I'm drying this baby off, I'm looking at five things specifically. Color. I'm looking at heart rate. I'm looking at respirations. I'm watching the respiration. I'm looking at muscle tone and reflexes. The baby should be flexing their arms and legs as I move. excuse me. As I move and I'm stimulating them. They're drawing up their legs and pushing them back out. They're nice and flexed and toned. Okay. So those are some things I'm looking at. As soon as I get most of the moisture off. I'm going to get my stethoscope, and I'm going to start listening to lung sounds. Of course, I want them to be clear, and I'm going to use a pediatric stethoscope specifically. One thing you need to know, respirations are 40 to 60 per minute in a newborn, and that's considered normal. I am going to count for one full minute, okay? That's very important. During this time, again, I'm watching color. I'm watching baby moving around, the reflexes, the tone. As soon as I get respirations, I'm going to listen to the apical pulse for one full minute, okay? Again, normal heart rate for a newborn is 120 to 160, and I want to make sure that it's within that, okay? All right, so I've done that. Then I'm going to get a temperature. One thing that happens to newborns is that they become what we call cold stress. We're going to do an apical pulse. I'm going to demonstrate to you, instead of putting the thermometer this way, you take a chance of slipping the tip of the thermometer through the back or behind the arm. So we want to go hold the arm up and put the probe of the thermometer directly in the axilla area. Wait till it beeps. We get a temperature, and we want to document that, okay, to know exactly where that baby is at this moment. All right. We continue to look over our baby, again, watching for tone, watching those respirations, making sure that that baby is not going to start decompensating on us. One thing with respirations in a newborn, they're not going to be regular. That baby is going to cry, you know, breathe heavy and hard and fast, and then maybe slow down, and then breathe fast again, okay? And the same thing with the heart rate. It's going to be very variable, so you're going to need to be aware of that. The next thing we're going to do, after we've dried him off and we've checked his heart rate, we know that the five things that we look at initially are within normal limits, and that is called Apgar score, and we're going to talk more about that later, and you're going to have some lessons on that throughout the semester and also in clinical. We're going to start measuring the baby. What is one thing the parents all want to know? They want to know how long the baby is, and they want to know how much he or she weighs. So when picking up the baby, I always put the palm of my hand on the back of their neck and put my fingers, my thumb and fingers, on either side of the head. I grab their feet either above or below or underneath and pull them together and hold them together, okay? I'm going to pick my baby up carefully, bring them over. Prior to this, I have placed a cloth over my scale, and I have zeroed it out. So, again, I'm going to lay the baby carefully, and of course, even though There's a lining over the scalp. This is very cold, and these babies are going to startle very quick, easily. But one thing I always want to do, it's okay, darling, is keep my hand over this, over the child at all times, because it only takes one split second for that baby to grab it, one of the sides of the scale, and flip out. So we're going to weigh it in kilograms, and then, of course, for parents, we're going to switch it over to pounds so they know how much the child weighs. Some scales have a measure on the side of or on the bottom of the scale. This one does not. So I'm going to bring him back under the warmer so he stays nice and warm for us. Again, we want to make sure that temperature maintains within a normal level, okay? But if it doesn't have a tape measure on the scale, we're going to, like I said, we're going to use a paper tape measure. We're going to start at the crown or the occiput of the head, okay? And we're going to, I usually turn the child towards me because this makes it easier this way, okay? And sometimes it takes two people, especially if this is a big kid or he's very active. So I'm going to put the end of the tape measure at the occiput. I'm going to stretch out one leg. I know, darling, I know. I'll be done in a minute. And I'm going to measure from crown to heel of the foot. And again, this baby doesn't stretch out, but in the newborn, they will. And I want to measure this in centimeters, okay? Let me get it untwisted here. All right, so we'll say this leg is stretched out. I'm going to... my tape measure broke. it's 44 centimeters, okay? So we want to make note of that, okay? The other thing I'm going to measure is their head circumference. It's okay, darling. You're all right. This goes around the head, right above the brow, okay? And again, they're still kind of slippery, even though we've gotten most of the moisture off. Centimeters. Okay. All right. Bring it across to the end, and it's 38 centimeters. So you want to take note that the length of the baby was 44 centimeters. And the head circumference is 38 centimeters. The reason we want to measure the head circumference is, one, that is one of the parameters that physicians, as they continue, you know, babies go in for their preventive care and determining normal levels of growth and development, that is one thing they measure. And the head is probably the fastest growing or the brain is the fastest growing organ in that first 6 months of life. And so it's very important that we note what the size is at birth so that we can continue to monitor that. All right, so we've done the head circumference. It's also called FOC. We've done the length. We've done the weight. Then we're going to just do a quick general assessment over this baby. We've done the vital signs. I'm going to look at the nipple line at this point. Okay, and make sure they're even. I'm going to look at the eyes in relation to the ear, the pinna of the ear, and make sure it's level on both sides. I'm also going to place a finger in their mouth and feel for their hard palate. We want to make sure that is intact. And the other thing we're checking is their sucking reflex. That's a reflex that they have at birth, and which they need so they can eat, right? So we want to make sure that hard palate is intact and that they are sucking. Another reflex we check is the rooting, and that's by taking your finger and just rubbing it along their cheek next to their mouth, and they'll turn towards that direction, and that's called a rooting reflex. The next thing that we look at is what we call the fontanelles. They have an anterior and a posterior fontanelle. The anterior is about 1.5 to 2 centimeters diamond shaped. The posterior, and that's located right here in the between the frontal and the sagittal bone. The occiput, or the posterior, is back here between the occiput bone and the sagittal. And that's more triangular shape, and it's about a half to 1 centimeter, okay? Also called soft spots. So we want to feel these very gently. We want to make sure they're not sunken. We want to make sure they're not bulging. Those could indicate issues or concerns that we need to notify the healthcare professional. So we want to note those, all right? Then I'm going to pick the baby up and lean him over my arm, and I'm going to look at the folds in his neck, okay, to make sure he has normal folds. I'm going to look at his spine to make sure it's all intact. There is one condition called an occult spina bifida where there's not necessarily an opening. There's what we call an occult opening where you don't really see it on the outside, but it may have a slight defect on the inside. And many times with those children, you'll see a little, like a hair tuft, a little patch of hair, okay? So you want to, again, make sure that spine is straight and note that if there's any type of little patch of hair. You want to look at their anus. We're not going to put anything in their anus to see if it's patent. We, of course, hope that they maybe had a bowel movement and that proves that it is patent. And then, of course, we monitor and we watch and we teach mom and dad to let us know as soon as they identify or have to change a diaper that the child's had their first bowel movement. We're going to look at their hands. We're going to look at the creases in their hands. One of the signs of Down syndrome is a straight line, a palmar crease. And so we want to look at those and make sure those are normal creases. We are also going to look at the creases of their feet. The more full-time the baby is, the more sole creases they are going to have along their foot. The more premature, the fewer they're going to have. We're also going to check a babinski reflex. Again, that is a reflex they are born with. It does go away, but at birth it is considered normal, and we would want to check that as well. And of course, moms and dads are asking, you know, how many fingers, how many toes? Be sure you say 10. Don't say 5, because then they think they only have 5. Or if you say 5, say 5 on each hand or in foot, okay? All right, so those are the main things that we're going to do. We've measured them. Now we want to identify the baby. The baby does not leave the nursery unless special circumstances. Maybe NICU is there and they feel like it is best to get that baby to NICU so it can be managed appropriately. So babies are always going to have 2 armbands. They're going to have one on one wrist, okay, and they're going to have one also on their ankle, okay? So we want to make sure that we identify them correctly. And, you know, many times there's another nurse or another staff member in the delivery room helping with those little things while you're caring for the infant. I know, I'm messing with you, aren't I? I know it. I know. Okay. Yeah. And of course, you want to do this as quickly as you can in a real situation so we can get that baby over to mom and dad to hold. And a lot of times you'll see that we'll have the significant other or whoever's in the delivery room with mom come over and watch what we're doing. One thing we're not going to demonstrate here are the medications that we give, but you will see this in the delivery room. We use an eye ointment called aquamycin. Erythromycin that we're going to put in the eyes to prevent any type of transmission of infection from mom to baby. And we're going to give vitamin K or aquamycin in the thigh, okay? This is also to help with bleeding tendencies, okay? To keep them from having those bleeding tendencies at birth. The other thing you may see given is a hepatitis B vaccine. This is started many times in the hospital And it's many times given in the delivery room if mom and dad have chosen to do so. Okay? So I'm just going to change my gloves real fast because those are, been soiled a little bit. And I'm going to get this baby wrapped up, and I believe we've done everything. I may check another temperature if it's taken a little while, just to make sure baby is maintaining his temperature. Get a diaper on this kid before he decides, she decides to pee or poo everywhere. That's not always a good thing. Makes a mess, makes more work for all of us, okay? So if you don't know how to diaper a baby, maybe practice a little bit, okay? Now you are going to be responsible for carrying out this assessment during the simulation when you're with me on OB Clinical, okay? But I wanted you to have an opportunity to see this demonstration, to see what the expectations are prior to coming to clinical. Then I'm going to get some warm blankets, and I always get two. Again, cold stress is huge for these kids, okay? So we want to do whatever it takes to prevent that. So I usually get two of them. I pick my baby up, put him underneath. If you're with me, I'm going to have you hold hold the baby, or I'll hold the baby while you get the blankets ready. I'm going to put a cap on the baby's head. Again, they lose a lot of heat through their scalp. So by putting a cap on their head, this really will help. We want to wrap them pretty snug, okay? They've been used to being in a very snug environment. So we want to continue that, and it also helps them stay warmer, okay? All right, little one. We're almost going to go see mom and dad. Yeah. Sure are. And the more snug and more warm these blankets are, the better this baby is going to be able to stay, maintain their temperature in those first few hours. All right. And that's the end of our demonstration.